decided to go train and turn my NPR station and talk about Trump, and he's going to be, in 24 hours, the president-elect, I suppose, and all the investigations about him still doing his, running his businesses rather while being president, and the conflict, and I don't know, I just, the only thing that happened different was when Obama was elected. I'm trying to think of my lifestyle, how my lifestyle changed. Like, I was forced to get health insurance. I'm a small business owner, so it's expensive. And if I didn't have it at the end of the year on my taxes, like, I had to pay the penalty. That's the only thing that mattered when he was from his election, as far as my lifestyle. I don't know. I still went to Starbucks. I still made the same amount of money, because ultimately it's up to me how much money I make. And, man, there's so many people that are... I understand he said some very rude things, Trump, but every senator, every House of Representative, if you tracked them, do you know how many rude things they've said and how inappropriate their behavior has been, every single one of our political leaders, it's I think it's just because he's the in the hierarchy, the highest on the food chain there, that people are definitely picking on him, and I'm not supporting him by any means. Just saying, I think people need to take a little more personal responsibility and not get their get all upset just because he's going to be elected. I mean, at the end of the day, what's it going to change? Maybe I'm being naive. I don't know. Time will tell. But I know I'm responsible for how much money I make, what my fitness level is, what I put in my mouth, how fat I get. I'm responsible for just about everything concerning me. And I think people need to take more more just personal responsibility. I don't know. Well, here I go to train. See you in a triangle choke. Okay, guys, quick tip for the arm triangle. What we'll do is we'll go from crossbody position. I'm going to try to turn his chin this direction so I can get my knee on belly. This arm's already the underhook. What I'm going to do is I'm going to walk it up to here. Here's a key fundamental. When you grab the tricep, make sure all four fingers are going down. You'll probably start low by the armpit because he'll be resisting, of course. But when you grab, get a good hold of it, base your hand out, let your foot come around into the full mount. And then from here, press your hips down. Get the heels underneath their hamstrings. Press as you put your head here. Walk your fingers up a little further. And then you can start to adjust whichever grip you like. If you like this grip, I prefer like a rear naked. Grab, you can finish from here. I know his arm is here. I would push it across normally when I'm doing it, but just for the sake of talking and doing this, holding it. So head replaces the hand, hand grabs here or here. Finish. If you're having trouble, of course, when they're moving, you may want to move to a side control, sprawl out, and squeeze. All right. All right, guys, give that a shot. Don't miss that key of getting all four fingers right in the back of the tricep and see if you can walk it up towards the elbow to gain more control.
Send the vibes out. I hate this one. I can't stand it.
All right. Meeting of the minds.
Here it is.
Let's do this.
So, basic questions that I like to write down. Number one question I wrote down here is, what is your goal? Like, what is your goal for the business?
For this business, great question. Honestly, like, just to throw it out there, I want to gross $30,000 a month.
Okay.
That's been my goal. Yeah. When I was across the street, I was doing really well, but I was only, it wasn't anywhere near 30. It was like, I was going like 18 to 20, but I had like two. But yeah, I would just think maybe ignore everything else but jujitsu and just treat it like that. That's
like, it's this life. It's your passion. You already talked about it. That's all we talk about. Why not talk about it to other motherfuckers and then influence them into coming in? Get them all excited. Just how you sound when you talk about jujitsu. Like, when I talk to people at work that have no idea what jujitsu is, I'm like, James choked me out last night. Now, you know, like, I get so excited. And they're like, oh, yeah. But you'll catch a few dudes who really intrigued. Really? Where's this at? And that's all that. That's all it. It's a seed that sprouts. Where's this at? Boom, light bulb starts flickering on. And that's how you fucking bring him in. Yeah. Oh, it's just in town. Oh, where are you? Oh, I'm in Valpo. And if we have different locations, like Park YMCA. Oh, yeah, he actually hosts a class there on Wednesdays from 6 to fucking 7. Cool, you'd stop in sometime. Trial session. Whatever. Yeah. However you want to do it.
Right.
Oh, where are you from? Crown Point? Well, there's a fucking YMCA in Crown Point, too.
Yeah.
He hosts a class there from 6 to 7.
Yeah.
Stop in
looking
sometime.
Over up.
You know, it's like go to the customers. Customers don't always come in. If you build it, they might not fucking come. You gotta go to
that's why proven over and over how many businesses fail.
Right.
They don't come.
They don't come. Go to them. You gotta knock on the door, man. I know it's so old.
So you guys wanna like meet every week?
I'll do this every day.
Talk about it. Do ye.
I think I'm about to cut it here and check and see if
your
I'm gonna nail
that.
Oh, I got it plugged in.
My lungs ripping all the skin from off my bones. I'm